We have seen previously that the set of all rational numbers is going to be somewhat tense. But tense, that tense we actually haven't defined rigorously. Probably we can think like this. Suppose that we have two rational numbers, A and B, then definitely A plus B by 2 is also going to be a rational number, and A plus B by 2 is going to be between A and B. But now we are going to make actually a much stronger statement. Instead of saying that between any two rational numbers we can find another rational number, we are going to show that between any two real numbers we can find a rational number. That means that in the real line the set of all rational numbers is very tense. Between any two real number we can find a rational number also. We are going to prove this using the Archimedean property just now we have established. Recall that the Archimedean property we proved using the axiom of completeness. Therefore, the density of rationals in R is also going to be a consequence of the axiom of completeness. We are going to see that the set of all rational numbers is dense in the set of all real numbers. But precisely, the statement is the following. For every two real numbers A and B, with A less than B, there exists a rational number R satisfying R size between A and B. So the density of Q in R, the statement is precisely this. Whatever two real numbers we choose, A and B, and without any loss of generality, we may assume that A is less than B, we can find a rational number between, strictly lying between this A and B. This is what the density theorem actually says. We are going to divide the proof of this statement into a few cases depending upon the sign of A and B. So as the first case, we will assume that A and B are not negative. Therefore, to start the proof, assume that 0 less than or equal to A less than B. That means A and B are not negative. What are the other cases remaining? The other two cases are that A is below 0 and B is above 0. That means A less than 0 less than or equal to B. And the other case is that A and B both are below 0. We will deal with these cases later. Now we have to find a rational number R such that R lies between A and B. How does a rational number look like? It looks like an element in the form M by N, where M and N are both integers. Since we are assuming that A and B to be both positive, we can safely assume that we want an M by N in such a way that M and N are both positive integers. So we have to find R belongs to Q such that A less than R less than B. That is, we have to find M, N natural numbers such that A less than M by N less than B. This is what we have to finally show. To find an M and N satisfying the condition that A less than M by N less than B, where M and N are natural numbers, we are going to work backwards. So we are going to see if such an M, N exists, then what are the properties that we have to impose on this M and N? Or what are the properties that M and N must definitely satisfy? So we will check this inequality first. A less than M by N less than B. Remember that we don't know whether such an M by N exists or not. So we need to find such
natural numbers m n. So if this inequality is going to be true, then this implies that na must be less than m, must be less than nb. And if na less than m less than nb, where n and m are natural numbers, then automatically it becomes true that a less than m by n less than b. Therefore, these two conditions are, these two inequalities are equivalent. Now, when can we find an integer m between na and nb, where na and nb are two positive real numbers? We know that in an interval of length greater than 1, definitely there exists an integer that is neither of the n points. That means, suppose that we consider the interval na to nb, and suppose that the difference between these two endpoints, the difference is, suppose it's greater than 1, then definitely there exists an integer m such that na less than m less than nb. That is, if nb minus na greater than 1, then there exists an integer m such that na less than m less than nb. So we can find an m between na and nb provided that we have the difference greater than 1. So what is meant by difference greater than 1? That is, this is possible if b minus a greater than 1 by n, or 1 by n less than b minus a. But actually we have seen this, that b is greater than a, therefore b minus a is positive. And we have already seen as a part of the Archimedean property that if we have y greater than 0, then we can find a natural number n such that 1 by n is less than b minus a. Therefore, such an n can be found. This is achievable. This is achievable. So, by Archimedean property, there exists natural number n. Now we are going backwards. Natural number n such that 1 by n less than b minus a. This is not first. So if 1 by n we are finding less than b minus a, what happens is, if we are going backward from through the same route we traveled up to here, then 1 by n is less than b minus a, or b minus a into n is greater than 1. B minus a into n is greater than 1, or nb minus na greater than 1, or nb greater than na plus 1. So up to here it's fine. We can find an n satisfying nb greater than na plus 1. But now, if we take the integer part of na plus 1, suppose that we are taking the integer part of na plus 1, then integer part of na plus 1 is going to be, since na is positive, na plus 1 is positive, therefore integer part is going to be less than or equal to na plus 1. Therefore, this is, integer part is going to be like this. So na plus 1 is going to be greater than or equal to its integer part. Call this number as m. So we have nb now greater than m. Therefore, nb is now greater than m. So one of the parts we achieved, that we wanted m and n, so in such a way that na is less than m and m is less than nb. That one part we have already achieved. Now what is remaining? So the remaining thing is na less than m. Why is this true? That is the last question that we have to answer. Remember that this m is the integer part of na plus 1, and the difference between the number and its integer part cannot exceed 1. Not only that, na plus 1 is a positive real number, and therefore the integer part is obtained by dropping the decimal portion of na plus 1. So this is very obvious, that na is less than or equal to ma,
sorry, m less than or equal to n a plus 1, and this is less than n b. So this is because the difference between n a plus 1 and its similar part cannot be more than 1, and if you are taking difference of 1 from n a plus 1, you will be getting n a. Therefore m lies between n a and n a plus 1 for sure. The only thing we have to make sure is that n a is strictly less than m. So the only possibility we have to rule out is that n a is equal to m. That possibility we have to completely avoid. If n a equal to m, what will happen? So the question is this: can n a be equal to m? If n a equal to m, that means that n a is an integer. In this case, n a is an integer. So if n a is an integer, then n a plus 1 also will be an integer. So if n a plus 1 an integer, then what is the integer part of n a plus 1? This is going to be equal to n a plus 1 itself. But we have n a equal to m, and the integer part of n a plus 1 is equal to n a plus 1 itself. But integer part, we are saying that it's equal to m. All these things are landing us into some kind of contradiction. So this leads to the n a equal to m will lead to a contradiction. Therefore this is not possible. Therefore n a is strictly less than m. N a is strictly less than m. Therefore we have found an n and m in such a way that n a is less than m and m is less than n b. So if we club these two inequalities, we get n a less than m less than n b, and therefore a less than m by n less than b. So we establish that we can find in natural numbers m and n such that a less than m by n less than b. Since m and n are positive integers, m by n therefore definitely exists, and m by n exists between a and b. So the claim that we made in the beginning, we have justified. What is the claim? If 0 less than or equal to a less than b, then we can find a rational number between a and b. So if 0 less than or equal to a less than b, there exists a rational number r equal to m by n such that a less than r less than b. Now what are the cases remaining? We have assumed here that a is greater than or equal to 0. Now we have to, of course, we have in the beginning itself assumed that a is less than b, so we need not worry about that condition. The only condition we have to worry is if a becomes less than 0, what will happen? So in the second case, assume that a is less than 0 and this is less than or equal to b. In this case, we can proceed as follows. Since a is less than 0 and b is greater than or equal to 0, suppose that we take the negative of all these numbers, we will get that minus b is negative. So minus b less than or equal to, minus b need not be negative, minus b is less than or equal to 0, and this is less than minus a. So a is less than 0 or minus a is greater than 0. Now remember that by the Archimedean property, second part, if y is a positive number, then we can find a 1 by n between 0 and that positive number. Therefore by Archimedean property, there exists natural number n such that 1 by n is less than minus n. Therefore if you combine this inequality, if you put this 1 by n also there, we will get minus b less than or equal to 0 less than 1 by n. Of course 1 by n is greater than 0, less than minus a. And if we reverse the inequality again by using a minus sign, we get a less than minus 1 by n less than
0 less than or equal to p. Therefore, we get minus 1 by n as the rational number between a and b. And in this case also, we have verified the density property. Now, the last case remaining is that both a and b negative. Now, last case. A less than b less than 0, because p equal to 0 case we have already handled. Now in this case the proof is somewhat similar and it's much more easier if we use the first part. If a less than b less than 0, then we have minus b 0 greater than minus b less than minus a. So minus b, this is positive, this is also positive. So we can find, we have already established in the first case that we can find an m by n between these two. So there exists natural numbers m, n such that minus b by minus b less than m by n less than minus a. If we again reverse the inequality using a minus sign, then we get a less than minus m by n less than b. So in this case also we have found a rational number between a and b. Therefore, whatever is the sign of a and b, we can always find the rational number between a and b, and hence we have completely verified the density theorem of q in R. As a consequence of the density theorem for q in R, we can now show that the set of all irrationals is also dense in R. So the statement is precisely the following. If A and B are real numbers such that A less than B, there exists an irrational number T satisfying A less than T less than B. That means between every two rational real numbers, there exists an irrational number. To see this, we are actually going to use another interesting result, which is that suppose that we have a rational number and which is non-zero, and suppose that we have an irrational number, then the product is again going to be irrational. So the first claim before verifying this statement is the following claim: let R belongs to Q, R not equal to zero. Let S be an irrational number. Then we claim that RS is irrational. This is actually very easy to see. So in most of the cases when it seems that it is a little bit difficult to directly establish this thing, we can just go in the contradiction route. So we assume, if we assume that RS is rational, we will see what will happen. Suppose RS is rational. So RS is rational means that RS is going to be equal to some R dash. Therefore, RS equal to R dash belongs to Q. Since R is not equal to 0 by our assumption, S is equal to 1 by R into R dash. But we know that the product of any two rational numbers is again a rational number, because suppose that we have M by N and suppose that we have P by Q, then M by N into P by Q will become equal to MP by N cube. Therefore, it's again a rational number. Therefore, this belongs to Q. Therefore, S belongs to Q. S belongs to Q, which is not possible because we have assumed already that S is an irrational number. So whenever we have an irrational number and a rational number which is non-zero, the product is going to be again an irrational number. We are going to make use of this to show that the set of all irrational numbers is also dense. So our trick is the following. We are very much familiar with one particular rational number, that is square root of 2. So if we multiply m by n and square root of 2, then we will be definitely having an irrational number, where m by n is a rational number. We know already that between
A and B, they always exist M by I. So the question is to find, we have to find the irrational such that A less than T less than B. You know that we can find M by N between A and B, but we want M by N into some irrational number to get T between A and B. But if you multiply, if you know that A less than M by N less than B, if you are taking that M by N, if you are multiplying that with some irrational number, say 2, then it will not be lying inside A and B. So if we use this A less than M by N less than B, and if you multiply with root 2, what happens is A root 2 less than M by N root 2 less than B root 2. But this M by N root 2 is not lying between A and B, but it lies between A root 2 and B root 2. So this root 2 is not actually necessary for us. So how to avoid that? If you multiply with root 2, if you are multiplying with root 2, and if you don't want that root 2 to be present there, then already there must be a 1 by root 2. So that is a trick that we are going to apply here. Instead of finding a rational number between A and B, we are going to find a rational number between A by root 2 and B by root 2. So in that case, A by root 2 less than M by N less than B by root 2, and on multiplication with root 2 will finish everything. But of course, there is one small issue, that this M by N should not be equal to 0, because if you are multiplying 0, then M by N into root 2 cannot be an irrational number. So we are just safely avoiding that possibility, and for the time being we will assume that we are finding an irrational number which is not equal to 0 between A by root 2 and B by root 2. By density theorem, we have there exists a rational number M by N in Q such that A by root 2, instead of A and B, we are choosing A by root 2 and B by root 2 less than B by root 2. Now multiply it throughout with root 2, because it's positive, the inequality won't change. Therefore, A less than M by N root 2 less than B, provided M by N not equal to 0. But what will happen if M by N is equal to 0? Suppose that M by N is equal to 0, then what will you do? If M by N equal to 0, what will you do? Because the density theorem in Q, the construction we performed in the case of the density, to prove the density theorem, we never argued that the M by N that we are finding is non-zero, isn't it? But in fact, in the proof of the theorem, though the density theorem is not saying that M by N is going to be non-zero, the way in which we found M by N actually tells us that M by N is a non-zero rational number, because we have taken there M and N to be a natural number in the first case. Even otherwise, without relying on that particular proof, because we cannot actually rely on it, we cannot actually say anything based on a proof, but we can depend only on the statement. Using the statement itself, if the density theorem gives 0 as the rational number between two real numbers, how can we find a non-zero rational number itself? Or in other words, can we modify density theorem saying that given A and B, we can find a rational number between A and B which is not 0, or we can find a non-zero rational number between A and B? Can we say that? That is actually very easy. Suppose A less than M by N less than B and M by N is 0, then replace A with M by N. Therefore, there exists M dash by N dash such that M by N, which is 0, less than m dash by n dash less than b. But m by n is 0 and a is less than, and this is not equal to 0, it is strictly greater than 0. Therefore, a less than m dash by n dash less than b, and this is not equal to 0. Therefore, rational theorem, this density theorem, using the same density theorem, we can actually find a non-zero element, non-zero rational number between a and b. Therefore, in the previous situation where we were having the trouble that if m by n is equal to 0, we cannot find out an irrational number by multiplying that m by n with root 2, that can be completely removed. So we can find a non-zero rational number such that a by root 2 less than that non-zero rational number less than b by root 2, and in that case we will be getting that irrational number as m by n into root 2. Therefore, the setup for irrationalities also bends in the setup for real numbers. So the setup for rationals is very dense. Between any two real numbers there is a rational. Set of irrationals is also dense. That means between any two real numbers there is an irrational. And these two rationals, these two sets, rationals, irrationals, are densely packed throughout the real life. So that completes the density theorem for Q as well as the density theorem for irrationals.